Hey, what's up, garden friends? Jeff here. How's everybody doing? Hope you're doing well. I'm great. Backlit. Thought I had this set up perfectly. Totally screwed that up. Let's try that again. A little bit. Well, there's just, no matter what I do, there's going to be sun behind things.
Suppose that'll have to do.
Overwintering plumerias. Had a few requests to talk about this. Y'all are making my job pretty easy these days. I have a list like a mile long of people just saying, hey, do a video on this. I appreciate, thank you. Making things easy for me. Plumerias, gorgeous tropical plants. They have the most fragrant, fantastic flowers on them. I zoomed right in on one that's starting to die off. They smell great, they're easy to grow. They're popular plants for a good reason. So this is not necessarily as much of a how to grow plumeria video. This is about overwintering, which I assume if we're here for the overwintering part, how to keep them indoors, and you already know how to grow them, right? Because you've had them all growing season. Yes?
Oh.
This is simple. You're going to like it. With plumerias, the first thing to keep in mind is when do you take them inside? And that's going to be prior to your first frost. The growing apex on these are what's the most delicate. Apex being that very center right there. That's where all the new growth comes from. It's where the flower buds form and come out. That's what's the most delicate. So you want to get these plants indoors before you have frost, because that's the first part of the plant to be damaged by the cold. For good health and to keep them flowering and to have those flowers next year, it's best practice to make sure that no damage occurs down there in that middle. You can store them any place that stays above 40 degrees, technically above frost or freezing, so above 32 degrees is fine, but 40 degrees is more of a safe zone. Below that, you start to run into potential issues with rot if moisture gets down there around the root of the plant. I just put mine in my garage. I put them in my garage, it stays frost-free, and I put just a little piece of styrofoam underneath them to insulate the roots of the plant from the cold cement that's just below them. Keeps the cold from wicking up from the ground onto those roots. As we move into the fall and the day lengths start to become shorter, and things get more dry and more cool, the plumerias, they naturally go into their own dormancy. So by the time you're moving them inside for the winter time, when it's starting to get cool, if you're waiting for it to get near frosty temperatures, but not too frosty temperatures, that's when the plant's going to be triggered to start to yellow out, drop its leaves. When they get to that point, they don't need light or water. If there's no leaves, no water. Like, that's just kind of the biggest rule with plumeria. Don't water them. There's like one small exception, we'll talk about that. Just because they don't need light or water when they're dormant doesn't mean you can't keep them in a well-lit room. That'll be fine if you wanted to keep them with your other houseplants, just because you like the way they look. When they drop those leaves, they turn into kind of a fun looking, like a pickle tree, and you want to embrace the pickle tree. You can have that around. You don't have to like store them away into a dark closet or anything like that. The plants know that they're not supposed to be growing, and as long as you don't water them, then they shouldn't. As I mentioned, the leaves will start to yellow and get sickly looking. It'll start from the inside of the plant and work its way out. They'll just naturally fall off. You can allow them to just naturally fall off on their own. That's what I usually do. But if you're bothered by the messy aspect of it, you can go in and pop these right off. I don't really bother with that, but you can if you want to. The reason I don't pull them off on my own is because I found that when you just let them fall off on their own, the plant doesn't spend nearly as much time trying to heal where that was pulled off of the stem. You just don't have to worry about pathogens and things like that entering into the plant as much as you do when you rip them off, because like I said, there's not as much of a like open sore there when they fall off on their own. And that's pretty much it. They don't need light, they don't need water. Keep them frost-free. If you have them in a garage, maybe protect the pot from a cold floor, but otherwise, that's pretty much all there is to it. Probably the easiest plant to overwinter in the house during the winter time. There are a few other things to talk about, just common questions that I get with the plumerias. The first one has to do with those stems shriveling up. It's totally normal. These stems, especially once you're getting closer towards springtime and they've been inside for a long time, when you may start to notice some shriveling in here on these stems. They'll get kind of pressed looking and more wrinkly. That's totally normal, don't worry about it. Once the plant breaks dormancy and it's time to start watering it again, those will plump right back out. Rare circumstances, perhaps you have a really, really long period where you have to keep them inside, like maybe your frost starts in September and you can't take them back outside until like late May, you know, like up in where, Wyoming, somewhere like that. I don't know. That was just a guess. I have no idea. That's a long time for the plant to be inside and be dormant. And just because it's inside doesn't mean it's going to be dormant. You can move them in before they need to go dormant and keep them growing. They'll find that dormancy on their own as the light starts to wane away from them. But if you do have a really prolonged period where the plant is actually in that dormancy and that shrivel becomes really drastic down towards the base, sometimes it may appear that the upper portion of the plant is going to lose support and might split from the bottom. That doesn't happen very often. Usually when that happens, it's more related to rot, not because of desiccation. Desiccation being the drying of the plant. Shouldn't have to worry about rot as long as you're not watering the plant. If you water it when it's dormant, rot could be a problem. So if that shrivel does happen, go ahead and dig around the base of the plant. Look for foul odors, any blackness, discoloration, then that could mean potentially that there is rot going on down there. If it's bone dry and you're not seeing anything that seems like there's any sort of pathogen or infection, something nasty going on down there, that's when it's like the one exception to go ahead and water the plant while they're in dormancy. But I would change the conditions that the plant is in, meaning try and get the plant into a position where it's going to get more light and more warmth, and don't do a full flush of water through that pot. You don't need to do the traditional plant watering where you get the water to run all the way through the pot and see it come out the bottom. We're talking just a sip, just a surface sip on the top of the soil. And that's still risky. But if you're caught between, okay, do I let the whole plant topple over? Maybe try and let it rehydrate. Then that's an option. There's issues either direction you go there. So it's something to only do if you're absolutely certain that the plant is shriveled to a point where it's going to die. The next option is to embrace the shrivel. Sometimes that will happen. It shouldn't, but it can. It's okay. These propagate so incredibly easily that if that lower portion does shrivel to a point where it can't hold up the rest of the plant, you can just cut it and then stick that back into some soil. And when it's time to move it outside and get it warmed up, water it, it'll take root and you have a new plant. It'll be okay. As long as it's not rot, it'll be okay. All in all, watering a plumeria while it's in dormancy is a very big no-no. It should only be done if you're absolutely certain that it has to be done. That's actually one of the reasons that I kind of like to store mine in my garage, because it's cool, relatively dark outside of the grow area that I set up. It's cool and relatively dark. And on the one occasion where I did have to break its dormancy because it just looked way too desiccated, I was able to move it into the house where it was warmer and there was more light. And it had been in dormancy for 5 months, so I knew that it was okay to go ahead and do so and resume watering and break it out of that. By having it in a cool, dark space to stay, it made it a lot easier to light it up, basically, and warm it up and trigger it to come out of dormancy. The main reason I had to do it was because the grip, it's a long story, don't worry about it. It's probably not a problem you'll encounter. There was a lot of water in the area, and I think some of it got into the pot, and then it like came out of dormancy, and then it was like, oh wait, I'm not supposed to, then it went back into dormancy. It's a whole thing. They should break dormancy within 4 to 5 months. That's about average. They can go a little bit longer, they can go a little bit shorter. Doesn't mean something's wrong in either direction. Growing tip here will start to swell. It'll start to put out these longer pieces that should be curled inward like little claws during the dormant period. Those will elongate out. They'll unfurl some leaves. I don't resume watering until there are usually two sets of new leaves, or at least one set's opened up and the other set is just about to open up. And then I don't resume fertilizing until probably, I'd say, 2 to 4 sets of leaves have come out. Like this growth tip right here, if we were to just see this portion right there, and that were on the plant and this were still bare stem, that's when I would resume fertilizing. The reason it's good to wait and let them put out a few new leaves first is to just make sure that the plant really is breaking dormancy and going to stay that way, because sometimes the plumerias will try and trick you, or they'll get confused, I should say. Doesn't happen all that often. It just means that they've detected a big change and they think it's time to wake up. So the downside to keep them in the garage is that it's harder to control the climate in there. So while it's typically cool and cold during the winter time, it's not always the case. There can be days in January where it might be 60 degrees, sun hits the garage and it can get pretty toasty in there. And then all of a sudden, a week later, I'll start to see movement in here with these new leaves coming up out of the middle. I don't want to see that in January. Those will usually go ahead and pause back on their own as long as they're still nice and small like these are right here. If they elongate out much more than that, they'll usually get black and crispy and crumble or curl back inwards, which is okay. As long as the very tip here stays alive, everything's fine. That's what I would want to see. I don't want the plant to break dormancy in January. It wouldn't be a very happy plant in the house, or my garage, I should say. And then I think the only other point to mention here is to watch out for pests and insects. You may encounter spider mites or scale on these sometimes during the winter. The nice thing about it, these are super easy to get bugs off of. You can just take a sponge with your insecticidal soap and just wipe those trunks down. That's it. So you don't have to get inside a lot of nooks and crannies. With the exception of that growing apex, the spider mites sometimes will build a little factory in there. You need to get in there and spray. Don't want that to happen because they'll dry out, you know, just eat the heck out of all that tender growth, those dormant little growths that are sitting in the middle. Just be careful when using insecticidal soaps or whatever your pest management is that you're not going to get too much water or really any water down there into the soil of the plant. Because again, no leaves, no water. That's the rule with Plumeria. That's it. Super easy, right? I know I went on for a while just to give details in case people have some odd circumstances they encounter, but it's nothing. Absolutely nothing. Just take them in the house, don't water them. Clean up the leaves when they fall on the ground, and that's it. Don't let frost hit them. Watch for bugs. It's typical houseplant stuff. And now for the part of the video where I ask you to comment down below. Offer your tips, tricks, suggestions, whatever you have to add to the conversation so we can all grow and learn together is always appreciated, and I thank you for it. And just say hi. I love talking to everybody. Hope everybody's doing well, having a great day and a great life, and everything's just going beautifully for you. Got a puppy down here, banging into the tripod, making things nice and shaky. Excuse you, out of there. Yeah, you know better. All right, as always, and most importantly, everybody, keep on growing. Bye-bye.